Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the United States of America and to the Republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Good evening and welcome to the 86th Annual East Rockaway High School Rock Rivalry. It is truly amazing that we are all here tonight. Just a couple of weeks ago, it didn't appear likely that we'd be able to fill an auditorium, but our patience has paid off. I want to thank you all for sticking with us as we've navigated the ever-changing regulations over the last 2 years. It is clear that Rock Rivalry is back. So I think that deserves another round. I want to take this opportunity to thank our Board of Education, many of whom are here tonight, along with Superintendent Ruiz and Assistant Superintendent Scrio and DiTomaso, for their unwavering support of our students and our district. I want to thank our school administration, our teachers, and our staff for all they have done over the last couple of months to ensure this year's Rock Rivalry was a success. A special shout out to our great advisors and our Rock Rivalry coordinator, Ms. Alicia Brown Group. And finally, if you didn't know already, your children are truly special. No matter their role in this year's Rock Rivalry, each and every student that participated has played an important role in what you will see here tonight. And it didn't matter how many changes in schedules or anything that we threw at them, they just kept on going. They are creative and talented. They are collaborative and skilled. They are dedicated to more than just winning the cup, they are dedicated to each other. We know that this is the lasting value of Rock Rivalry, and I am thrilled that they get to show us what they've been working so hard on for so long. So take pride in what you see here tonight. Take pride in what we as a school community represent and can achieve when we are united in the best interest of our children. So one more round of applause. A few general announcements. Emergency exits, front and back, please check where the closest emergency exit is to where you're sitting. Please no flash photography. Please remain seated during performances because there are performers coming down the aisles during the entrances. Please silence your cell phones now, please. The small gym closes at the beginning of the seniors' performance. So in between entrances, you can still get down there. Everyone is invited to remain in the auditorium after the last performance. The announcement of the winner will be held in the large gym, which will be live streamed through the NFHS network. So the same link that you use to watch athletics, you can actually watch the announcement of the winners, but that will be for the students only in the large gym. A couple of things, please support our PTA and the Ed Foundation out back, and each of our classes selling refreshments in the small gym. Now it's my pleasure to turn the mic over to Ms. Fancourt.
Thank you, Mr. Finkman. Welcome and thank you for supporting this fine tradition as we get back to the swing of things. I am happy to report that our morning assembly today went very smoothly. We were happy to have grades 7 through 12 in the audience and give the middle school a taste of what a Rock Rivalry entrance looks like. Our senior class happens to be the only class to experience a traditional Rock Rivalry, and that was their freshman year. So essentially, the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors are performing to be judged for the first time on stage. You wouldn't know it though. All four classes continue to amaze with their talent and leadership skills. It was a pleasure to watch the student this morning clapping, cheering, and laughing at and with one another. I hope that spirit carried over throughout this weekend and when we return to school next week. Each class has worked tirelessly the past 6 weeks to perfect the performances you will witness tonight. I am in a unique position as I see the growth and progress each class makes week by week. I know tonight you will see their best performances. Behind the scenes, the supporting cast includes our class advisors, Ms. Rebecca Mantle, Mrs. Emanuela Matthews, Mr. Scott Gerken, Mr. Luke Tesserario, Mr. Hugh Howard, and Mrs. Suzanne Volpe, who have spent much of their waking hours this week with your children. In addition, we know many parents have opened their homes and ran around doing all the last-minute errands to help the classes get tonight together, and we thank you. I'd also like to thank the PTA for everything they do and for sponsoring our chairman brunch this Sunday. I would like to thank the Board of Ed. I would like to thank Mrs. Maney, who's been so wonderful and helpful with live streaming, and of course, our administration. I would like to thank, at last, the past alumni who have volunteered their time this evening to judge the performances. So without any further ado, it is now my pleasure to present the freshmen, the class of 2025, in their first Rock Rivalry entrance titled Italy's Most Wanted. Unneeded attention to ourselves.
Any ideas, Michelle? Where's the next hit?
Extra, extra, read all about it.
I think we just found it.
Found what? Oh, I looked at the full moon today and tomorrow night. I haven't seen one of those since before going behind bars.
Oh, not that, Freda. Our next target, the golden diadem, Museo Taranto's finest, most valuable item. It's a perfect hit. We just gotta get past the two lousy security guards.
Whatever you say, boss.
Count me in, Michelle. Let's hit the museum tonight. No one will see it coming, and I have the perfect plan. Oh, this is my favorite exhibit. Here we have the painting Birth of Venus. was said to be a very, very good leader. Then we have the woman with veil, along with the painting of Francesca Maria della Rovere, was believed to be a little bit of a hothead back in her day. Then we have the statue, St. Laurent Gianna Lorenzo Bernini. I know it is a mouthful. St. Laurent, who, well, has known to have been a tad bit narcissistic. Any questions? Okay. Next, we have the statue of Aragorn, who is notoriously funny. Hey! No flash photography! I wasn't done! Then, we have the one, the only, very motherly Empress Helena. That's a good question. Anyways, this is the youth in toga, along with the statue of Rebecca, who is said to be very competitive and a team player. It is about closing time.
Wait, what's that?
I almost forgot. This is the golden diadem of Crown, which is part of our newest exhibit.
Whoa,
how much is
that crowd?
It's priceless. Any more questions? Okay, folks, that's all we have time for today. Have a good one.
Hey. Wait, Bobby, my Lego!
I have to go!
No!
Man, what a long day.
Yep, you got that, Rico. Looks like everything is good. We have the statues, the paintings, and the golden diadem.
Man, I can't wait to take my feet up the bush and see honey I brought from home. They say honey was wonders in the skin.
I don't know about you, but I'm gonna go to bed.
I might too. Oh, hey, you got the full moon tonight, tomorrow?
It might just be my head, but I feel like some strange things go on during full moon.
Nah,
remember, guys, we get the diadem and we get out without making a peep.
There's a bee!
Come on, Fredo, look what you did!
Would you too high? Your security's coming!
Who goes there?
Show yourself! I could have swore I heard something. Ah. I can't believe you, Freda. We've robbed bank, been to prison, been chased by cops, and you're afraid of a little bee? We will come back, get the golden diadem, tomorrow night, so don't mess it up.
Okay, boss.
It could be dramatic, diplomatic, climatic.
Let's all come and go. Let's all come and go.
Hey, you guys hear about that new Facebook page?
Yeah, now you know you're from Italy page?
Yeah, they're crazy. They really got nothing better to do.
Appreciate us. Did you see those burglars in the paper? Us two could easily catch them.
You know what? Yes, yes, we can. Everyone thinks we're just some sleeping security guards, but we're hard working and
it's a hard not life. Alright team, let's get to work. When with Vale, do you have the bowl of fruit? What about you, Vale Rebecca? Do you have the pot of honey? Did you get the Legos you've been told of? What about the rope? Do you have it, Arity? And for Solana, do you have the drapes? Alright, we have never dealt with any of this before, and we must be brave and help each other out, because we are a team.
Everyone knows what they must do, so let's stop those bandits. Hands in, you call it, Venus.
Team on three. 1, 2, 3, team!
Alright, places, everyone!
There it is, the golden diadem.
This is going to change our lives forever.
Sure is. Freda, you'll get the crown,
Sunny.
You'll be on lookout, and I'll be the getaway car. I'll keep it running. And remember, all you have to do is sneak, rabbit, and go.
Get in that exhibit and get the crown in my hand. Get in that exhibit and get the crown in my hand. Go fill my pockets, I'm gonna be a rich man. I said sneak, rabbit, and go. I said sneak, grab it and go. I said sneak, grab it and go. Well, they can't do nothing.
love and I'm going. Some brand new ski masks, the pops are on our back. Some brand new ski masks, the pops are on our back. We look so friendly, but these hearts are cold and black. I said, sweet, grab it and go. 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 Well, they can't do nothing and say their dog on go. Go! 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 I'm like a selfie stick crawling around on all fours. I'm like a selfie stick crawling around on all fours. I can look it, tell you don't love me anymore.
You can't go wrong, I believe in us, my girl. You can't go wrong, I believe in us, my girl.
So get that crown and don't make any noise. I said, sleep, grab it and go. 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 Well, they can't do nothing to save their dog on go. Sleep, grab it and go.
You stay over there and stay watch.
All right.
Quit it. I said cut it out.
Cut out what? I didn't do anything.
Fine. Sonny, I'm done with you. Show me some respect every once in a while. I'm your sister, for goodness sake.
What are you talking about? Just go get the diadem and let's go.
Fine. The crown is finally ours. What the? Honey! Honey!
Wasn't that statue just over there?
I did too.
Bless you. Wait, wait, you're a statue moving and talking? What?
Did I ask
what you're doing here? I was cleaning the golden diadem. I'll bring it back to shop. I'll have it back in no time.
Oh, okay, yeah.
You
can go on and take the parts of artifacts and fit on the land. Well, I've got a harder for Rico Rita to get you.
Alright.
Yeah, there you go.
You too. No, you can just have it.
Good job, everyone. We saved the museum. Hold on. Wasn't there one more robber?
Everybody, here's one coming.
Sonny, Freda. Sonny, Freda.
But what on earth are you doing? I said get the crown and get out. I'm not even gonna ask where your sister is.
What do you think? I just tied myself up in a corner?
Maybe the statue didn't.
Actually.
Okay, now you're talking crazy. Let's just get the crown and get out of here. Oh, great. Not these two.
Michelle, they're coming.
I know. I heard the night guard say they're coming.
Oh, no, the statue.
What?
Don't you ever come around here?
try to do.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Get outside!
Oh! Oh! We're on the job! We're on the job! We're on the job! Let's go! Let's go to the Facebook page!
I once heard her yell off of your head.
Everyone quiet, the judge is coming.
I don't see her. Today, we will be deciding if Michelle Russo, Sunny Randazzo, and Fredo Randazzo are guilty of breaking and entering into the Museo Nazionale di Toronto. Our witnesses are Rico Pimoco and Rita Catalano. I'll be calling Rita Catalano to the stand. Rita, are you currently employed as a security guard at this museum?
Yes, ma'am.
And did you and your partner, Rico, in fact, catch Michelle, Sunny, and Freda trying to steal the golden diadem?
Yes, ma'am. Rico and I heard some strange noises, so we went to go check it out. And that's when we saw these three trying to steal the golden diadem.
Well, Michelle, Sunny, and Freda, do you have anything to say for yourselves? Oh, as if I haven't heard that one before. These three have been on the run from the cops for almost 3 days now after breaking out of prison using plastic cafeteria spoons. Jury, mind you that Michelle, Sunny, and Freda have a pretty hefty criminal record dating all the way back to 1985 where they had stolen an ice cream truck.
Oh, I remember that quite well. It was my big birthday.
Did I give you permission to talk?
Sorry, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. So if there's no other questions, I'll hand this decision over to the jury. You may consult with one another.
Guilty!
It is done. Michelle Russo, Sunny Randazzo, and Freda Randazzo, you are guilty and are sentenced to 20 years in prison. And I'd like to congratulate Rico and Rita for the act of bravery. They will receive 50,000 euros. Congratulations.
Whoa! Grazie! Three people are for five, but Rico and I are resilient.
Want the cup to stay? We
spot.
Same spot. I haven't moved.
Is there a setting that you could change? I was watching in my classroom. The kids look like ghosts.
Isn't the lighting different where it was swinging? Like, I couldn't see them in the front.
So do you see it on there? They look like ghosts?
Oh, there? I know exactly what you're talking about. I think it's because all these lights are off. And when they were at the front of the stage at the very end, it was, they were in the dark. Because there's no spotlights on them. So it's a very basic thing. I'm not a tech person. You're the tech person.
Oh my
God, Kevin
said
hello to me.
What?
Kevin said hello to me.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. He was
very
sweet. Made me feel good.
He's a good boy. I don't know where he is, but.
I think I saw him
before.
This morning, wasn't it? Because when they were all at the front of the stage, did you notice that they were all dark? Like they don't have spotlights or anything else? I don't know. You said that it's not, they look like ghosts. But we can't do anything about it. We don't have a camera.
I don't know why the lights are dark.
Did you notice that it was different?
Yeah, most of it was dark.
No spotlights. I understand that. Oh, that's what I was thinking.
I don't think it's there.
I just I think the problem is like for this, there's just not enough light in here.
There should be a little bit. Turn them on. The spotlight.
That's for the spotlights.
They're on.
They're
on. The
what?
It is whatever. It is what it is.
Oh, me. Where is it? What the lights?
An ace card. Of course it's the first card you pull up by. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Oh, I was so beautiful. I could have been a star. But there's another path for me.
Oh, Connie, there's no way to be a drama queen.
Here we go.
These days bring me joy and sorrow. With times we took from others, I found my love, but some tried to keep us apart. I fell apart at something so great. With friends that I loved so much, but I knew I had to forget it forever.
We keep denying and we always try to forget, but we always remember when and how. You try to banish me and our memories from the day. But when I see it like this, I started this whole wreck. I just have to admit that it's all coming back to me, but I know it exists, and it's hard to go back. I hate to see my past, and it's all coming back to me. It's all coming back, it's all coming back to me now. Think the moments of gold and all the funny late nights. There are things I never do again, even though I know you were right. Remember that night of endless pleasure, the one we had to allow. Baby, baby, when he asked me like this, he came in such a flash. I just have to admit that it's all coming back to me now.
Connor, come on and tell us what exactly came back to you.
Oh, well, if you insist, it all came back to me in 1928, when we first met each other.
Clearly it didn't come back to you. We met in 1930.
Why? That is impossible. I was 19 and you were 21.
Yeah, in 1930.
Oh, yeah. Anyways, it all started, my you.
And that's when you started flirting with me. See, you're even twirling your hair.
Wait, but you made the first move!
Hey, Connie. Did that work for me?
Give it off, babe. Connie's never.
Well, listen to your set, though.
Those two are always fighting.
Well, we all fought, especially about me joining our gang.
You mean my gang?
Of course, darling.
Yeah.
We stayed up late that night figuring out a plan.
Yeah, I'm running for help. What's his name? Was our getaway driver?
I could have sworn Jimmy Yes was our getaway driver.
Why? His name is Jimmy No. Secondly, just leave him talking to me.
No, this is our story, so we're both gonna tell.
Whatever you say.
Thank you.
hurry up. The car's running out of gas at gas station cheap nowadays.
And that was our first successful crime.
Fly, did you see that?
See what?
Ace. He left an ace card in the display.
Well, we call him Ace for a reason.
Which is exactly how the detectives started to catch on.
Speaking of detectives, let's see how they started to put the clues together.
Detective Garrett.
And I'm
Lex.
This is Dave
Patsy. What's your name, miss? I'm Ann. I don't understand how someone could just steal from my jewelry store.
Detective, we're going to see you in the display case. Oh, great. You can make me pop an Operation Wild Card.
Okay. Well, I get it because it's a playing card. That's why. Did you get that?
Here we go again with your stupid jokes, Larry.
Keep on looking. Great job. It was very nice to meet you, miss.
And we'll get to the bottom of this.
Thank you guys for all your help. Please find me, thieves.
We've been HIPAA, a smooth criminal.
Thank goodness I found no more evidence.
Yeah, for that mission, that wasn't the only heist we did, Lai.
Well, the next crime, this one happened a little unexpectedly, if I do say so myself.
Ah, I remember. We were on a date and you had a great idea.
I thought it was your idea. We were walking down the street and you stopped in front of a brick wall.
I could have sworn it was your idea, Blythe.
Oh yeah, you're right. Anyways.
Where's Ace? That guy's a criminal.
gotcha. Sorry about that.
The body of a big girl!
Into the car. I wonder why.
Look, he left something painted on the wall, but I can't quite see it.
Put on your glasses, Blaine! It's an ace car!
So tell me why!
Test all that jewelry.
Tell me why!
There's no clues at the crossing.
So tell me why!
We can't find these things.
We want it our way, are we? Much smarter.
Yes, sir. Much smarter.
I know it's not too late, cause I want a donut.
Hey, fun.
Look what we have here. You can bring back the station.
We've been hit by a smooth criminal.
Officer, take this evidence too.
Yes, sir.
Wait, whose coat was that?
You didn't see? Lacey Susan wasn't paying attention and sprayed to his back, causing him to drop it.
You think she sprayed him on purpose?
I doubt it. They're too scared to ever get put in jail again for that to happen.
Again?
Yeah. Anyways, this is just a couple steps closer to how Detective Gary and Larry found out that it was us.
So, Gary, want to sing another duet?
Maybe you don't keep messing up, Larry.
Great. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Larry, are you out of mind? I said me.
Maybe. Okay.
Yeah, you make me crazy.
Yeah, you make me crazy.
Oh, you make me crazy.
Oh no, this is where everything goes wrong.
I want to burn Jared! I said stop! No! I think I might have tricked my back in that process. Let's carry on.
Connie, you won that fight in my heart.
Thank you, Black. You make my heart go cartwheels, even when I go crazy.
Speaking of crazy, this fight escalated quickly.
How about commanders and traps? My duty speak.
Ah, my duty is more bad.
Now no more.
All over that safe and go time.
Yes.
I remember stealing over $2,000 over there.
I remember pulling $800 out of the cash register.
Connie, you were collecting checks about file cabinets.
Why? That can't be possible. I was in the cash register. I remember seeing Benjamin flicking all over the $100 bills.
Connie, you were at the file cabinet.
Whatever, just continue on with the story.
Alright. Anyways, so we were there for the rest of the night, and when what's his name finished loading up the getaway car, we said goodbye to him one last time, which kind of made me sad.
Turn the radio off! Turn the radio off!
My work
here is done.
Guys, wait up!
I know. You see, somehow the world will change me.
This place really is a mess, huh?
Yes, this place is, that's right there.
Anyways, we need to search every inch of this place. Put on your gloves and we know if you find any evidence.
Yes, sir! Hey, get over here, I think I found something.
What is it?
This, look, it's a pet.
Larry, that lady belongs to the thing.
How would you know, huh?
Because there's seven other ones sitting right on the counter.
Dang it, I thought I had something.
What's the bear?
Is that an
ace car?
Nice job, man. Bring some cars so we can bring it back to the station.
Come on.
Listen, everyone. The first piece of evidence was found, but we need to keep looking. We're not leaving until we find more evidence.
Yes, sir.
So while we were hiding away, these boneheaded, idiotic police officers kept searching, and they found a photo.
Not just any photo, Clyde.
Look what I found here, boss.
Oh, perfect. That's just what we were looking for.
Well, sir, it wasn't me!
It's a clear shot of the culprit, and now it's time to track him down!
Just take the
Ryan, stop it!
Attention all citizens! If anyone knows or recognizes Bly Barrow, please report to the police immediately. The person who turns them in will receive a $1,000 award. Jumping to the floor once I heard that radio.
Your heart dropped. No, my heart dropped. My name was on call.
I was still scared.
Not as scared as me.
Whatever, just continue on with the story, Bly.
We need to get out of the city now. What happened up there? There's cops everywhere. And this.
Oh. Why is there an A card on it?
Hey, you seem a little quiet. Anything you want to confess?
What? No. Oh, no, no. He's... Tell us!
And that was the last time we saw Ace. All right, let's put the flat back.
Wait, why? You're forgetting our last goodbyes to him.
Oh, we can skip that part.
Oh, hey!
We just got a smooth criminal. Oh!
You know, Blind, I hear Ace is finally getting out of jail today. I think it's about time to go see him, maybe.
No, I can never forgive him. He framed me and basically said he would love me. We were engaged.
Whatever, Blind. I'm going to gather the rest of the gang to come with me, and you come if you want, I guess.
Well, Jimmy Nono and the Lazy Susan are back in jail again, so who are you going to get? Johnny or Peter, and what's his name?
His name is Johnny Susan. I'll see you later, Blind.
Fine, I'll come.
It's been so long. How are you guys?
You know, life is pretty good after Ace messed it up.
Yeah. Oh my God! I'm so excited to see all of you.
See some of them. Have you seen
one? I've been watching. And guess what? I'm here.
So if you guys didn't want to see Ace.
I don't know. After everything he did, I don't think I could ever forget.
Oh, 2, 3. Here we go.
Dom. How are you?
Hey, you're all over the place now.
Yeah. How's that coming out?
Okay.
Works well?
They can hear us. Step aside.
Okay.
I tell you, I have a good day.
Thank you. We are living in an inferior world. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
One, two, three. Mmm. One, two, three.
Thank you.
sounds good.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one quick announcement before we move on. Well, check it out, right? Before the juniors perform, one quick announcement, please. Just so everyone is aware, the small gym is now closed. It will reopen after the winners are announced. At that time, we ask everyone to collect any belongings or props that you have in the small gym, because there is no guarantee that it will be there tomorrow. And just as a reminder, after the seniors perform, the winners will be announced in the large gym for the students, but you can watch the live stream of the announcement on your phone through the NFHS network. Okay? Enjoy the rest of the show.
Thank you.
That would be so cool too. To witness the debut of my newest game, Planet Z. In this game, our contestants will be fighting the evil alien villain in outer space to fight and free all the mistreated alien citizens. And hey, as a reward for being the first person to beat my game, our lucky winner will be going home with $5,000. That's easy money for me. Don't get too cocky, kid. You'll have to have a few tricks up your sleeve to beat my game.
Please, I'm not taking any advice from somebody wearing white pants after Labor Day.
Whatever, kid. It's your loss. Take it or leave it.
Oh my gosh, I've been studying and researching this game for weeks. I can't believe I get to see it in person.
You know, Ashley, I have to complain to Spotify for you not being named this week's hottest single.
For your information, guys, I have a boyfriend. Brief.
Well, I don't see him.
Yeah, trust me, you don't want to.
Okay. Playing hard to get, I see. Don't worry, sweetie, I love the chase.
Are you guys seriously flirting with this masterpiece right in front of us? I have to play this game. I need to be the first to beat it.
Whoa, not so fast. I won 3 state championships. If anyone can beat this game, it's me.
Hey, nothing is getting in between me and a new pair of shoes. I'm going to be the first to play.
No, I'm going to be it.
Stop it! What are you
doing? Get off!
What? Whoa! What's going on?
Hey, nerd, you know this game? Fix it!
I don't understand what's happening. I can't help it.
What's happening? There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
be the way out to beating the game.
So, beating the alien villain?
Yeah, but by the looks of the villain on the ads, she looks pretty tough. How are we gonna beat her?
Please, you have a starting varsity quarterback on your side. If anyone can take her down, it's me.
Please, my grandma has bigger arms than you.
I'll just have to prove you wrong then. Peace.
What do we do now?
Maybe Ashton knows a way to help.
I wasn't exactly eavesdropping, but yes, I can most certainly help you. What exactly do you need help with?
The game? You know, Planet Z?
What game, silly? This planet's as real as the drama on The Real Housewives of Neptune.
So, you're saying you know nothing about this evil alien we're supposed to be?
Well, one person does come to mind, but we don't like to say her name. She's always listening. She came here long ago from a galaxy far, far away. No, I'm not pointing to anything. Just trying to set the scene for you. She's the most powerful alien in all of the galaxy. The most wicked, vile, backstabbing alien to ever rule Planet Z. Last year, she raised tax prices.
No!
Every year she's been in power, the aliens have been treated horribly.
Maybe we can help each other out, though. We need to beat the queen to get your lives back. We need to beat the queen to beat the game.
Well, there is this secret weapon hidden in the mountains of Planet Z, but they say only humans could use it, so I don't think it would help.
I'm pretty sure that's perfect.
Oh, okay. Here I have a map passed down from generations and generations of those who have lived on Planet Z. Now, it will help you in your quest.
Thanks. Mouthwash, chicken, hemorrhoid cream.
Long list. Here you go.
Yeah, that's better.
Wow, thank you so much, Astra.
You're welcome. I have to go now. I have to go pick up a prescription. And it's definitely not a cream.
Okay, according to the map, it says go this way.
Wait. What do we do about Bryce?
Don't worry about him. He's a
varsity quarterback.
He'll be fine. Come on.
Begging for my mercy, it's so sad. Pathetic.
fortunate souls in pain from me. This one longing for approval, that one wants a better life, and it will help us. Don't look at me. You poor fortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come running to my lair crying, help, Zora, please! And who am I? I'm your queen. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone wasn't very nice, and I had to show them who was in control. Yes, I might have shown restraint, but trust me, I'm no saint. To you poor unfortunate souls.
Buddies? Well, they're not really my buddies. Just some dumb blonde and nerdy kid. One minute we got stuck, we were playing a video game, and the next we were told we're on Planet Z.
What do you want with our queen?
All hail queen!
That was pretty cool. You guys want to do that again?
All hail!
Okay, well, you see, I really don't belong here. I have a big game tomorrow, and I have to get back home. The only way is to defeat your queen.
All hail queen!
So, you like point or something? Left, right?
Yeah, buddy, she went right over.
Be quiet!
So you're looking for our leader?
Yep.
And when you find her, you're gonna take her down?
That's the plan.
Oh, okay, she's that way.
Thanks, man. Thanks, you're so nice.
Not so fast, human.
Oh. Hey, what's
you
going on?
You really thought we were gonna let you take our queen?
Oh, hell, queen!
Stop! I'm pretty to die!
You and your human friends are messing with the wrong extraterrestrials.
Okay. According to the map, once we get past the asteroid field, the secret weapon should be straight ahead.
Can we please take a break? I haven't stood this long since I waited in line for Harry Styles' concert tickets. And that was actually worth it.
Come on, Ashley. We need to get the secret weapon to go back home.
I didn't think it would take this long to get the secret weapon. And there's not even cell service here.
Is that really why you wanted to play the game?
I mean, duh. Why else did I spend all this time around video game nerds? Of course I wanted the money. Don't you?
Well, I just love video games. I wanted to be the first to beat Planet Z and impress everyone. You know what? It sounds stupid. Never mind.
No, that doesn't sound stupid. It's actually really cool how much you know about video games. It's really impressive to me.
Thank you.
Hey guys, what's up?
Oh my gosh. You look terrible. What happened?
Oh man, that alien villain is so tough. You should have seen it. We were going back and forth. We were like, pow, pow, pow. And I was like, pew, pew.
Okay, so you're saying you beat the villain, the most powerful alien in the whole galaxy?
Yeah, that didn't actually happen. But I made it to her lair. She wasn't there, though. It was just her alien goons. And they jumped in.
Well, what a surprise.
Hey, well, at least I'm trying to do something when you guys are just strolling around.
Actually, after you left, Asher gave us a secret map to find a secret weapon hidden in the mountains. It's so strong you get to defeat the queen.
Well, that's a great idea. Why didn't you say something sooner?
Well, you're off being a...
Oh, yeah.
Varsity quarterback.
And Asher gave us the map, like, right after you left.
Come on, guys. Let's go.
Guys, wait up.
meeting.
What? What, they're trying to take you out?
Are you serious?
Let the man in.
Ooh, hide this stuff.
I just received word that those filthy human goons are trying to remove you from power.
Remove me? What does that even mean?
They want to exterminate you.
Who did these? Think they are?
I don't know, Your Highness, but I think it's in our best interest to fortify your lair.
Yes. Assemble the guards.
Yes, Queen.
Now, General Zorzov, I need your best men on this job. Hey, General. Hear my shoulders this time.
Damn, those alien hospitals are amazing. I can already feel my legs again.
Forget that. We're at the mountains. Let's look for the secret weapon.
I wonder what this weapon even looks like.
Oh, it's probably so cool. It has like Queenslayer engraved on it.
No, that's too obvious. Maybe it's a flamethrower.
It's nunchucks.
You guys are so painful. Can we please just get this weapon and get out of here? This planet's making my skin dry.
Let's
Queen!
first time, and now I got the ultimate weapon. Does that mean we're stuck here forever?
I mean, it looks like it.
Hey, it's not that bad down in Planet Z. It's not Earth, but it's not too bad.
Well, if I had to be stuck in space forever, I'm glad with you two.
Yeah, you guys aren't as bad as I thought.
It won't be like back home, but maybe space isn't that bad. Come on, guys, bring it in.
Oh my god! I think we're home! Thank goodness my hair could not handle another second of space humidity.
Wait, but how did we get back?
Well, the goal of the game was to beat the queen, but it looks like it took the power of friendship to bring us back home.
Okay. Becoming friends with you guys was great and all, but are you telling me I could have avoided all this frizz if we just got along a little sooner?
Enough about your hair, Ashley. Guys, we just beat the game. Now where's my Super Bowl money?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Wow, folks. It looks like we have our very first champion and prize winner, Planet Z. And his name is, drum roll please, Oliver, is there anything you'd like to say to any friends, family, and maybe even future Planet Z contestants watching from a home?
Well, I'd like to say I can't accept this prize money.
Oh my god! And
I'm baffled by this. May I ask why?
It wasn't just me who beat the game. It took the power of friendship between me, Ashley, and Bryce.
I love you, bro.
Look, kid, that's real cute and all, but the rules of Planet Z specifically say, in Chapter 5, page 4, that there can only be one winner of my game.
What should we do now?
I don't know, guys. I don't need a new pair of shoes. I can just wait for the next line to drop.
Yeah, there's a Super Bowl every year. I don't have to go see the Giants lose in person.
I just love video games. I don't need the prize money.
Okay, this may sound corny, but I feel like we should just go home. Becoming friends with you guys is the real prize.
I'm gonna go home to the bar.
didn't see. I didn't see him. I'm right in the bus.
Thank you.
Thanks. Testing. You just have to be really close. Testing. 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 Okay. Is this on?
Thank you.
Atlantis is known as the Lost City and is said to be located in the Mediterranean Sea. This city was founded in 360 BC and protected by the Greek god Poseidon and ruled by his son Atlas. How did Atlantis fall into the sea, you ask? Well, many believe that the Atlanteans were being punished for being too greedy. They used their strength to conquer lands and take over nearby armies. The gods punished them by casting them to the life under the sea, and the city of Atlantis was destroyed by earthquakes and tsunamis. Atlantis is now occupied by the scariest creatures of the sea that come from the dark depths of the ocean. Over the centuries, the once beautiful, utopian Atlantis has turned to an evil, dystopian kingdom.
Please! Knuckle soup! They can't even swim in a straight line!
Hey, Poseidon!
Guys, this is bad. Like, really, really bad. Another one of these monarchs. You've got to be kidding me.
Yeah, this seems like the worst one yet. Taxes? Really?
Okay, but according to my calculations, help only goes at 2%, airbrush is only
about
1%.
Oh my god! Shut up! No one cares about that. Unlike you, I actually like spending my money on fun things. This showmobile won't pay off itself.
Showmobile? You don't even make minimum wage.
This man of tentacles needs to go, like, ASAP.
Yay, rebellion!
All right. Don't get your scales twisted. Come on, we can fix this. Let's just talk to the elders for some advice.
Yeah, they've been around for so long, they'll sure know how to help us. Good idea!
One way or another, we're gonna win this. We're gonna get her.
One day or another, we'll take it all back. We're gonna take it.
One day, take it this week.
not the plan check. The teams and the elders never conspiring against us.
No fair. I want it. You always seem like thunder.
We can't have rain without a little.
You two waltz in here, having a fit over the thunder, interrupting me and my bikini so teeny. Ugh, you guys just can't do anything right. You should be following them right now. Ugh.
Oh my god, dude, look, it's a gym!
You want to go get a lift in?
Yeah!
Ah!
Excuse me? Can I have a venti, half soy, non-fat decaf, organic chocolate brownie, iced vanilla, double shot, gingerbread frappuccino, extra whipped cream, foam, whipped cream, more whipped cream, upside down, double blended, and oh, with my ice!
I hate my job!
Oh, sorry, can you cancel that?
I do not get paid enough for this! Thank you.
champ. I was pretty wrong about you. You're pretty electric, if you know what I mean.
All right, back at you, Charlie. You know, we've been through a lot together with all the running around Madam Temple's been putting us through.
Yeah, she could be a real pain in the...
Who are you talking about now?
No one, Madam, no one.
You know, Gary the sea urchin. You know, he's always poking his nose around everybody's business.
Get it, because he's sharp!
That's so funny.
I'm not laughing.
Okay.
Sorry, Madam.
Jelly, Jam, we have some serious business to attend to.
What do you want us to do now?
Actually, Jelly, nothing. Absolutely nothing. You've done enough. I have to gather my army to defeat these pesky mermaids. My lovely citizens, gather, gather. Yes, very well. So as you all might have heard, the mermaids and the elders are conspiring against me. I mean, how rude is that? Woo!
Oh, I mean, boo!
I hereby declare you